you about one of the burning problems in current day practice. It is obesity and dyslipidemia. That is the commonest we see in a very young age itself. There are two principal factors behind it. One is extensive due to our lifestyle and food habits. All of them come from outside. And the intrinsic factor, cannot be that easily modified, that is due to genetic predisposition to dyslipidemia. So the National Cholesterol Education Program and other guidelines are there, wherein they have kept LDL as a hallmark. The current level of LDL, which is safe, will be 70 milligram per deciliter. So we must approach in the modifiable factors like our lifestyle, where you need more amount of activity and the quantum of food taken, a cholesterol free diet, and go for natural food to the extent possible. All these things will have long way to go and increase the longevity of the person also. Can we have a break? Children are not very active. They have forgotten the playground and they are confined to computer and the cable TV for most of the time. They resort only to indoor games. All these things contribute. And they go for junk food or fast food. And the oil which is used as a medium, which is used again and again, has been found to be one of the main culprits in today's life. All these things will have all to be modified. And go for natural food, green leafy vegetables, fruits, and day-to-day, daily activities. Go for long walking, that's the sprint type of exercise. All of them have long way to go. Reduce the amount of fat, reduce the amount of coconut and coconut oil input. Go for fish food. Take ample amount of fish oil also, omega 3, has been proven to have wonderful effect. And take statins if the levels are still high. Statins are the real wonders today in pharmacology, and is the one molecule which has been very extensively researched and studied in human body. And they increase the longevity of men. They have been tried in all primary prevention, secondary prevention, and they have been found to have wonderful effect in all forms of ischemic heart disease, chronic stable angina, unstable angina, or post bypass, or post plastic also. And they have been known to reduce the amount of ischemic events in the brain also. And they have been found to improve the renal function. And all the blood vessel related disorders have been benefited by the advent of statins. Very high in today's youngsters who have been working in a software industry because of the reduced amount of physical activity, where they have been having only mental activity and confined to chairs for long hours, 10 to 12 hours per day. I have seen repeatedly high amount of both cholesterol and triglycerides in them. They will have to change their lifestyle. And whenever they are free, at least in the weekend, they must resort to physical activity.